So growing up, there was a lot of things that me and my brother did. That was typical brother stuff. I remember one particular story. I was about 7 years old, and the house that we grew up in had a driveway that sloped down to the road. And so I thought I was cool. I just started learning my bike really well and how to ride it pretty well. And I thought, hey, I can go down the driveway, go off into the grass, and there was a ditch that went up into the road, and I could jump the ditch and be all cool and be like a daredevil kind of thing. So I did this a couple times, and then Jordan had the bright idea, because our neighbors had a much steeper driveway and had a much steeper ditch. And so instead of a ditch like that, it was more like that. And so being the physics whiz that I was, I was like, yeah, that'd be a good idea. But he told me, he's like, hey, Seth, you've got to go full speed. You've got to hit this thing as hard as you can to be able to get the good lift that you want. I was like, yeah, I want to do that. Yeah, that's cool. So I got my bike, got up my nerves, went down the driveway of my neighbor's house, and was going as fast as I possibly could. I went off the driveway, I hit the ditch, and typical physics stuff, I went into the road, my bike stayed in the ditch. So I did a Superman, crossed the handlebars, and laying out in the middle of the road, and here comes this minivan, and it's driving down the road, and it sees what the heck just happened.
It was far away. It wasn't about to hit him or anything.
So they're coming up over the hill, and they see this kid laying in the middle of the road, probably crying at this point, and my bike just a mangled mess. And then my brother standing over there, he's losing everything. He can't even hold it in. And so he goes,
well, at first I cracked up a little bit, and then I wanted to make sure he was all right. And so I ran out into the road and waved at the minivan and was like, Seth, man, you got to get up because these people need to drive through here. And they didn't almost hit him. They were a ways down the road, but they saw it happen. And so I finally pulled myself together, and I'm like, hey, man, it's going to be all right, because I knew he was going to go tell mom and I was going to get in trouble. And so I was trying to, sweet talk him a little bit. And so anyways, I pulled it together, and I was like, Seth, you got to get up, man. You got to get out of the road. You can't just lay here. And so he's like, man, I can't move. I can't move. And so I actually had to grab his ankles and drag him back out of the road. And then I just waved at the minivan and said, hey, you can come on through. And they were like, oh my gosh, what just happened? I was like, he'll be fine. And so I'm all serious at this point. I'm like, dude, you're going to be all right. Let's just go in the house and, you know, get you some Band-Aids and gauze and whatever else we needed. And so I'm totally serious this time, like trying not to get myself in trouble. And I see that he's okay. He's just a little skin up. And so I'm holding it together until I pick his bike up. And I'm trying to be nice and say, hey, man, I'll push your bike back to the road. Let's just get back up there and get in the house, cool off a little bit, and it'll be all right. And so I pick his bike up, and it's so messed up. I have to hold the handles like this to push it, and then it's like thump, 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 and I lose it again. And he's like, oh, man, I'm definitely telling mom now. And so I got in some pretty big trouble for that one. I think we had to get him a new bike, and but that was
this sort of thing was typical with me and Jordan growing up.
I mean, it didn't
up,
so. Happen that often, did it? I mean,
you were a few years older than me, so I was always trying to look up to you, wanting me to be my best friend, but you'd always try to put me up to stuff that would usually get me hurt. But it was fun. It was all good.
He survived, so
I'm alive, so
yes, sir. Always wear your helmet and knee pads and elbow pads.
So to all the younger brothers out there, it always happens.